Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. So today we go to the new chapter 3, which is system of equations and inequalities. So first we learn about the system of equations. So in system of equations, so you will be able to solve systems of linear equations in two variables and three variables using substitution method and elimination method, and then solving a system of non-linear equation. So ada dua jenis lah, satu linear and non-linear. So dalam linear kita ada two variable and three variable. So two variable ni sekolah menengah dah belajar dah, rasa form 3 dulu dah pernah belajar. Okay, okay, so tapi kita tengok dulu revision juga. Okay, okay, so for simultaneous linear equation, so we have two methods, which is substitution methods and elimination method. And in solving the simultaneous linear equations, so the key point is needs to be consistent in solving the equations. So kita kena consistent. Okay, so example this one, two variables. Okay, so for the linear equation, simultaneous linear equation of two variable. Okay, so dia ada dua pun boleh ubah, iaitu x dan y. So usually if two variable, we will have two equation. Okay, so kita akan ada dua equation. Okay, so two equation, two variable. Nanti three variable, three equation. Okay, so usually before this, okay, so sebelum ni kat sekolah menengah, so this one we label equation number 1 and this one label equation number 2. Okay, so by using the substitution method, from equation number 1 we choose, okay, so we choose which variable we want to search. Okay, so kita cari satu variable saja. Okay, so here I choose y. Okay, so from number 1 I choose y, so cari y. So y is equal to 2x minus 1. Okay, so from 1 ni kiranya kita kena cari satu variable je lah, single variable. Okay, so this one, find the equation in single variable. On left side. Okay, so sebelah kiri ni kita tinggalkan satu variable saja. Okay, so and then if you have y equal to 2x minus 1, okay, so and then substitute into equation number 2. So yang satu tadi kita dah guna dekat sini. So therefore we substitute this y equal to 2x minus 1 equation number 2. Okay, so you will have x plus 2x minus 1. So x plus y, so x plus 2x minus 1, which is equal to 2. And then simplify, x plus 2x, we have 3x. This one positive, negative 1, bring to the right become plus 1. So 2 plus 1 become 3. Okay, so after you substitute, if you notice here, so this one is the equation already reduced into one equation with one variable. Okay, so daripada dua equation, dua variable, dia berkurang kepada satu equation, satu variable. And then, so dah jadi macam ni, satu equation, satu variable. So we can solve value for x. Okay, so after you find the value of x, okay, so you calculate the value for y. Okay, so y from this equation. Okay, so jangan nak pakai yang ni, boleh nak pakai yang atas ni, satu dengan dua, tapi banyak kerja. Okay, so here already, you already found y equal to 2x minus 1. So substitute x, which is equal to 1 here. So you will have 2 times 1 minus 1. So the answer is 1. So therefore the answer x equal to 1 and y equal to 1. Okay, so this is the substitution method. And here elimination method. Okay, so for elimination method, yeah, so first, okay, so this one is two equation with two variable. two equation, two variable. Okay, so same as in substitution method, in elimination method also, we will reduce these two equation, two variable into one equation, one variable. So macam mana? So first, you need to choose what you want to eliminate. Okay. Okay, so which one you want to choose? Okay, choose the variable with same value of the coefficient. Okay, so cari yang variable yang ada coefficient, nilai coefficient yang sama. For example, this one 2x, but this one 1x, so 2, 1. So, jangan eliminate x. Y, here 1y, and here 1y, so sama. So, therefore, we eliminate y. Okay, so eliminate y. So, to eliminate y, negative y, what operation you should put here? So negative y plus with positive y. So negative y plus positive y become 0. And then 2x plus x. Okay, so this one equation number 2 plus equation number in equation number 1 plus equation number 2. So this one equation 1, equation number 2. So 1 plus 2. So 2x plus x we have 3x. And then negative y plus positive y become 0. 1 plus 2 become 3. Okay, so this one already reduced into one equation and one variable. And then after that, solve for x. Okay, so here we have x equal to 1. Okay, so to solve the value of y, so use any equation from equation number 1 and equation number 2. So here I choose equation from equation number 2. Okay, so from equation number 2, so I have x which is 1, so 1 plus y equal to 2, and then calculate for y, we have y equal to 1. Okay. So yang dikatakan konsisten dalam jalan kira itu yang inilah. Okay, so two equation two variable reduce into one equation one variable. Here also same, two equation two variable reduce into one equation one variable. Okay, so now we move to three variable. Three variable and three equation. Okay, so equation number 1, equation number 2, and equation number 3. Okay, so by using substitution method, okay, so from equation number 1, so we choose which variable we want to search. Okay, or we search a single variable. Okay, so kita cari satu single variable. For example, here I choose x lah, sebab kat sini already 1x. If I choose y, so here 2y, but here 3y, and here 5y. Here 3z, 4z, and 7z. Okay, so better we choose 1x. Tapi kalau tak ada, I nak buat macam mana lah. So terpaksa lah pilih. Okay. So from equation number 1, I have x which is equal to 8 minus 3z minus 2y. So become this 1. And then already found x, substitute this equation into equation number 2 and equation number 3. Okay, so because this one number 1 already used here, so dah pakai number 1 already used here, so yang ni tak boleh nak gantikan. Okay, so after that we substitute this one into equation that we didn't use yet. Okay, so yang belum digunakan, which is equation number 2 and number 3. Okay, so substitute into equation number 2, so we have here 2 times this equation plus 3y plus 4z equal to 10. And then expand and simplify, we have this equation y plus 2z equal to 6. And then substitute into equation number 3 here. So this equation number 3, this one is 2. So x is this one. So substitute here plus 5y plus 7z equal to 20. And then simplify, negative 2y plus 5y, 3y, negative 3z plus 7z, 4z. And this one, 8 bring to the right, 20 minus 8, which is 12. Okay, so we have this equation. Okay, so I write down again here. So y plus 2z equal to 6, and 3y plus 4z equal to 12. Okay, so this one become equation number 4 and 5. Okay, and I take this one, bring here. Okay, so sebab nanti nak gunalah untuk cari x. Okay, so already found x this one. Okay, so nanti kita nak guna untuk cari x. Okay, so just now, okay, so this one already become two equation, a system with two equation and two variable. Okay, nampak? Daripada atas tadi, tiga equation, tiga variable, reduce into two equation and two variable. Okay, so from this equation 4 and 5, okay, so we search one single variable, cari yang single variable. Okay, so in this case, I use equation number 4, because you already have y, one y. Okay, so become single variable. So which is y equal to 6 minus 2z. And then substitute this equation into equation number 5. Okay, so 4 already used. So we substitute into the equation that we didn't use yet. Okay, so yang belum digunakan. So which is 3 times y. So 3 times 6 minus 2z plus 4z equal to 12. And then simplify. Okay, so here we have this after substitute. Okay, so from equation number 5, okay, so we already reduce into one equation and one variable. Okay, and then we can solve for z. After we solve z, so substitute into y. So we have y equal to 0, and then substitute into x. Okay, so the value of y and value of z, so substitute into x. So we have value of x. So therefore, x equal to negative 1, y equal to 0, and z equal to 3. Okay, so next, okay, so same example. Okay, so this one I use elimination method. Okay, so this one equation number 1, 2, and 3. Okay, okay, so this one 3 equation 3 variable. So we need to reduce into two equation, two variable. Okay, so in elimination method, so we need to choose two equation. Okay, so two group of two equation. So 1 and 3, 2 and 3. Okay, so you can do any combination. Okay, so as long as this two group, there is a different. Okay, so jangan buat sini 1, 2 dan sini pun 1, 2. Ha, ni takkan dapatlah nanti, okay? So bila boleh pilih 1, 2, 2 and 3. Or you can choose boleh buat lagi tak? Sama je, okay? So 1, 2, 2, 3. Here I choose 1, 3 and 2, 3. Because I want to eliminate x, okay? So sebab apa nak eliminate tadi? Saya kata kita cari variable yang ada nilai perkali dia sama. For example here, 2y, 3y, 5y. Okay, so all of these 3 different, 2, 3, 5. For the z also same, 3, 4 and z pun berbeza. Okay, so but here 1, 2, 1. So at least these 2 have same value. Okay, so 1x and 1x. So I choose first group is equation number 1 and equation number 3. Okay, so from equation number 1 and equation number 3, so I want to eliminate x. Okay, so and then eliminate x, x minus x 0. Okay, so in order to eliminate x, so I should put a symbol here, 0 operation. Okay, so equation number 1 minus by equation number 3. So x minus by x 0, 2y minus 5y, negative 3y. Positive 3z minus positive 7z, negative 4z, which is equal to negative 12. So I have here negative, negative, negative. So I can simplify the negative, or I multiply all of this one with negative. Okay, so 0 times negative 0 lah, so saya tak tulis. Negative 3 times negative, positive 3y. Negative 4z times negative, positive 4z. And here, positive 12. And then for the second group, I choose equation number 2 and number 3. But here, equation number 2, coefficient of x is 2. Okay, so since I want to eliminate x, so therefore equation number 3, I multiply with 2. Okay. So equation number 3 this one, saya darabkan dengan 2. Okay, so we have 2x plus 10y plus 14z equal to 40. And then in order to eliminate x, okay, so I put the operation here, minus. Okay, so 2x minus 2x become 0. 3y minus positive 3y minus positive 10y negative 7y. Positive 4z minus positive 14z negative 10z. 10 minus 40 negative 30. Okay, and then I multiply with negative. Okay, so because here negative, negative and negative. Okay. So kalau tak ada negative, negative, negative ni, tak payah nak darabkan pun tak apa. Okay. So and then after that, after I multiply with negative, so I have this equation. Okay, so this one. Okay, so this one become equation number 4. And this one equation number 5. Okay, so already reduce into 2 equation with 2 variable. And then do elimination method for the system of 2 equation and 2 variable. Okay, so choose which one you want to eliminate. So here there is no choice because you 3, 7, 4, 10. Okay, so you choose whatever you want. So which variable you want to eliminate? Okay, here I choose eliminate z. Okay, so to eliminate z, since here coefficient is 10 and here is 4, so therefore equation number 4, I multiply with 10, and equation number 5, I multiply with 4. Okay. So, darabkanlah terbalik. So, yang atas darab 10, bawah darab 4. Ini kalau dia berbeza lah. Okay, so the equation number 4 times y 10. So, we have this one. 30y plus 40z equal to 120. And equation number 5 times by 4, we have 28y plus 40z equal to 120. And since I want to eliminate z, so what operation I should put here? So, for positive 40z, minus by positive 40 z become 0. Okay, so therefore 30y minus 28y, so we have 2y. This one 0 and 120 minus 120 0. Okay, so and then from this we can solve value for y. Okay, so y is equal to 0, and then calculate the value for z. So this one you can choose any equation lah. Okay, so whether number 4 or number 5. So, jangan pilih 1, 2 ataupun 3. Okay, if you choose 1, 2, 3, substitute y. So, you have x, z. Okay, so tak boleh nak selesaikan mana-mana sebab dia ada 2 variable. Okay, so we choose from this equation number 4 and 5. Okay, so let's say I choose from equation number 4. So, I have 3 times by y, which is 0, plus 4z equal to 12. Okay, so 3 times 0, 0. So, we have 4z equal to 12. And then, solve for z. So, z is equal to 12 divided by 4, which is 3. After that, we calculate the value for x. Okay, so from equation number 1. So, pilihlah daripada 1, 2 ataupun 3. Boleh sahaja. Okay, so from equation number 1, I have x plus 2 times by y, which is 0. Plus 3 times z, which is 3, which is equal to 8. Calculate for x, so plus this one 0, plus 9 equal to 8. So x is equal to 8 minus 9, which is equal to negative 1. Okay, so therefore, x equal to negative 1, y equal to 0 and z equal to 3. Ok, Okay, so dua method ni dalam contoh yang sama, dia akan menghasilkan jawapan yang sama. Okay, so first one, substitution method. So we have x equal to negative 1, 0 and 3. Here also elimination method also, negative 1, 0 and 3. Okay, so kalau buat, dua-dua method ni menghasilkan jawapan berbeza, tu adalah salah, okay? So this one, the example for the question lah. Okay, so biasanya soalan dia tak bagi tahu lah saya nak pakai substitution method or elimination method. Okay, so for me, okay, so I prefer to do elimination method lah. Okay, so saya lagi suka guna elimination method sebab dia lagi pendek. Okay. Okay, so for this one, this question, so this one equation number 1, number 2 and equation number 3. Okay, so first we choose which variable we want to eliminate. Okay, so for example this one, 1x, 3x, 2x, here 5, 10, 1, here 1, 2, 3. So all different. Okay, so all the coefficient of the variable are different. So in this case, so you can choose you want eliminate x or y. Okay, so tak apalah. Okay, so kat sini I choose to eliminate x lah. Okay, so eliminate x, so make two group. Okay, so first group equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay, so equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay, so in order to eliminate x, okay, so the coefficient of x should be same. So since here equation number 2 is 3x, so therefore here to make 3x, equation number 1 multiply with 3. So we have 3x plus 15y plus 3z equal to 7 times 3 is 21. And then equation number 2. So equation number 2, we have 3x plus 10y minus 2z is equal to 11. Okay, and then to eliminate 3x and 3x, so this one, the operation that I should put here is minus. So 3x minus 3x become 0. Okay, so 3x minus 3x, 0. 15y minus 10y plus 5y, and then 3z, positive 3z minus negative 2z become positive 5z. Okay, so 3z minus minus plus, so 3z plus 2z, and then 21 minus by 11, so we have 10. Okay, so you can see here this one 5, 5 and 10. So all of this one is multiply by 5. Okay, so sifir 5. Okay, so sifir 5 bermaksud kat sini kita boleh bahagikan semua ni dengan 5 lah. Okay, so divide by 5. Okay, so divide by 5. So we have here y, y plus z equal to 2. Okay, so this one equation number 4. Okay, so divide by 5. And then another one group. Here already equation number 1 and number 2. So another one group, equation number 1 and number 3. Or you can choose equation number 2 and 3. Tapi kalau 2 dengan 3 kat sini, sini 3x, sini 2x. So atas kena darab 2, bawah kena darab 3. So macam 2 kali kerja lah. Tapi kalau awak pilih 1 dengan 3, so yang atas this one, equation number 1, you should only multiply by 2. Equation number 3, no need to multiply. So, satu sahaja kerja. So, better you choose equation number 1 and 3. Okay, so number 3 times, oh no, number 1. Okay, so number 1 times with 2. So, we have 2x plus 10y, Okay, so yang ni saya tulis kat atas lah. Okay, so become y plus z equal to 2. Equation number 4. Okay, so next from equation number 1, so number 1 times by 2 and equation number 3. Okay, so equation number 1 times by 2, so we have 2x plus 10y plus 2z equal to 14, and equation number 3, which is 2x plus y plus 3z equal to 6. Okay, so to eliminate x, this one, okay, so we need to minus 2x with 2x. Okay, so 2x minus 2x become 0, so the rest will follow minus. So positive 10y minus y, which is positive 9y. Positive 2z minus positive 3z minus z. And 14 minus by 6, which is 8. Okay. So therefore, we have 9y minus z equal to 8. So this one equation number 5. Okay, so I copy again here. So y plus z. Okay, so y plus z equal to 2. And 9y minus by z equal to 8. Equation number 4 and equation number 5. And then next, choose which variable we want to eliminate. And before that, this one already reduced into 2 equation and 2 variable. Okay, so next, which variable you want to eliminate? So we choose the variable with the same value of the coefficient. So this one 1z and this one 1z. Why cannot? Okay. So this one eliminate z. Okay. Okay. So you can direct do it here. Okay. So z, what operation should I put here? With negative z in order to become 0. So positive z plus with negative z. So z plus negative z become 0. Y plus 9y become 10y. So this one plus pun tak perlu tambah. Okay, so sebab kosong ni kita boleh letak tambah. And then 2 plus 8, which is 10. Okay, so from here solve for y, because you already have 10 equal to 10. So y is equal to 1. Okay, so after you have the value of y, calculate the value of z. So from equation number 4. Okay, so I choose from equation number 4. Okay, so I have here y, which is 1, plus z is equal to 2. So z is equal to 2 minus 1, which is 1. And then choose an equation from 1 to 3 to calculate the value of x. So here I choose equation number 1 lah, because I have here only x. Kalau yang ni nanti kena pindah sebelah jadi bahagi 3. Ni pun kena pindah sebelah jadi bahagi 2. So x from equation number 1, x 5y. Okay, so from equation number 1, x plus 5y. 5y plus z equal to 7. Okay, so substitute the value of y and z. So I have here x plus 5 times 1 plus by z, which is 1, equal to 7. So x plus 6 is equal to 7. So x is equal to 7 minus 6, which is 1. So therefore x equal to 1, y equal to 1, and z also equal to 1. Okay, next question. Okay, this one also same lah, elimination. Okay, so I choose elimination method. Okay, so first we choose which variable we want to eliminate. So this one here you can choose either x or y lah. Sebab x ini 1x, 1x. Here 2y and here 2y. Okay, so only here y and here 3x. Okay, so tak kisahlah korang nak eliminate mana lah. Okay, so saya bagi contoh lain sikit lah. Tadi eliminate x je kan. So now I do to eliminate y. Okay, so eliminate y. Okay, so first eliminate y. First group I choose equation number 1 and 3 lah, because we have here 2y and 2y. Senang sikit nak eliminate. Okay, so from equation number 1 and equation number 3. So from 1, I have 3x plus 2y minus 3z equal to 9. And from equation number 3, I have here negative x plus 2y minus z is equal to 6. Okay, and then what operation that I should put in order to eliminate y? So positive 2y minus by positive 2y. So become 0, positive 0. Okay, so 3x minus negative x become 4x. And then 3z, negative 3z minus by negative z become negative 2z. Okay, so negative 3 minus minus plus. So negative 3z plus by z, negative 2z. And then 9 minus by 6, which is 3. Okay, so simplify. So you will have 4x minus 2z is equal to 3. Okay, so next, so from equation, okay, so this one 1, 3 already have. So next we can choose 1, 2 or 2, 3. Okay, so here I choose 2 and 3, eh? Okay, so 2 and 3. Okay, so but in 3 we have 2y. In equation number 2 we have y. So to eliminate, we should need to have the same value of the coefficient. So therefore, equation number 2 multiply with 2. So we have 2x plus 2y minus 4z equal to 4. Then from equation number 3, we have negative x plus 2y minus z equal to 6. Okay, so again, what operation that I should put here in order to eliminate y? So which is 2y minus by positive 2y become 0. Okay, so 2x minus negative x become 3x, and negative 4z minus by negative z, so negative 4 minus minus plus. Okay, so negative 4 plus by z, which is equal to negative 3z. Okay, so and then it is equal to 4 minus by 6, which is negative 2. Okay, so from here you will have 3x minus 3z equal to negative 2. Okay, so copy back here. So we have 4x minus 2z equal to 3, and 3x minus 3z is equal to negative 2. Equation number 4 and equation number 5. Okay, so next. Okay, so we have x and z. Okay, so choose which one we want to eliminate. Okay, so here kita tengok kat sini, for x here 4 and 3, for z here 2 and 3. So tak ada yang sama. So therefore, terpaksalah pilih apa-apa yang korang nak eliminate. Okay, so let's say here eliminate. Okay, so eliminate x lah, tak kisah. Okay, you want to eliminate z also can. So to eliminate x, since here 4 and here 3, so therefore equation number 4, we should multiply with 3. And equation number 5, we should multiply with 4. So equation number 4 multiply with 3, so we have 12x minus by 2 times 3 is 6z. Okay, equal to 3 times by 3, which is 9. And then equation number 5 times by 4, 4 times 3, 12x. 4 times 3 also again, so negative 12x. And negative 2 times by 4, which is equal to negative 8. Okay, so what operation that I should put here in order to eliminate x? I should put minus. Okay, so 12x minus 12x become 0. Negative 6z minus by negative 12z become positive 6z. So saya dah salah kat sini. So this one should be z. And then 9 minus negative 8 become 17. Okay, so from here we have 6z, which is equal to 17. So z equal to 17 over 6. Okay, so after you find the value of z, so we use the equation number 4 or number 5 to find the value of x lah. Okay, so we have here, okay, so from equation number 5, so we have 3x minus 3 times z 17 over 6 equal to negative 2. So from here we have 3x, okay, so minus 3 times 17, which is 51. 51 over 6 equal to negative 2. And then solve for x. So we have here negative 2 plus 51 over 6. So 3x is equal to 612. Wait. 2 times 6, 12. So 51. Yeah, so which is 39 over 6. And then divide by 3, we have 13 over 6. Then after you have the value of x, find the value of y. So here I choose equation number 2. Alamak, hilang lah pula. Okay, so korang dah salin kan? Okay. So from equation number 2, so I have x, which is just now is 13 over 6. Plus y minus by 2, z is 17 over 6 is equal to 2. So solve for x. So you will have y equal to 2 minus 13 over 6 plus 30 over 6. So you will have y, which is equal to 33.83 over 6. So therefore x is equal to 13 over 6, y equal to 33 over 6, and z is equal to 17 over 6. Okay. So next, okay, so simultaneous equation, okay, so involving linear and nonlinear equation. Okay, so in this case, so only substitution method that can be used for solving this type of simultaneous equation. Okay, so cuma substitution method sahaja. Okay, so example here. So I have equation number 1 is 1 and equation number 2 is 1. Okay, so if you can see here, equation number 1, there is a fraction. Okay, so if there is a fraction, so we need to simplify dulu lah. So kalau boleh hilangkan fraction, okay. So in order to cancel the fraction, so we need to multiply with suitable number or variable in order to avoid the fraction. Okay, if we look here, this one denominator here is over 2. So therefore we multiply by 2. Okay, so multiply by 2, we have 2x plus y equal to 2. Okay, so from 1 and here from 2. Okay, so from equation number 1 this one, okay, so yang ni tak payah tengok. Okay, so sebab dah simplify jadi bawah ni. Okay, so from equation number 1 this one, so we have y equal to 2 minus 2x. Okay, so we search a single variable this one. Okay, cari satu variable sahaja, which is y equal to 2 minus 2x. And then substitute this equation into equation number 2. Okay, so because we already use this one equation number 1, so substitute into equation number 2. Okay, so y equal to 2 minus 2x, here y square, so therefore we have 2 minus 2x square, minus by 18 equal to 2x. Expand and then simplify. So simplify, we have a quadratic equation, which is 4x square minus 10x minus 14 is equal to 0. Okay, so it is quadratic and this one is can be divided by 2, 10 also can divided by 2, 14 also can be divided by 2. So I divide with 2. So I have 2x square minus 5x minus 7. And then factorize, we have 2x minus 7 and x plus 1. Okay, so from this one, we have 2x minus 7 equal to 0, which is implies to the answer of x, which is 7 over 2. And another one, x plus 1 equal to 0. So this one, x is equal to negative 1. And then for x equal to 7 over 2, okay, so we search the value of y. Okay, so to search value of y, so we use this equation. This one yang kita dah cari tadi, which is y equal to 2 minus 2x. Y equal to 2 minus 2x. So which is equal to 2 minus by 2. X is 7 over 2. So the answer is 2 minus by. Okay, so 2 times 7 over 2, the answer is 7. Okay, so which is equal to negative 5. And for the x equal to negative 1, so y equal to 2 minus 2x, so we have 2 minus 2 times by negative 1, so which is equal to 2 plus by 2, which is 4. Okay, so therefore we have the answer, when x equal to 7 over 2, y equal to negative 5, and or x equal to negative 1, y is equal to 4. Okay, so another question. Okay, so this one. So here we have fraction. So how to simplify this one? Kita tengok denominator. So here we have over x. Okay, so do 1 by 1. So here over y. So cancel y dulu lah. So by multiplying with y lah. So x over y times by y, we have x. And 6y over x times y, so we have 6y square over x, which is equal to 5 times y, 5y. And then, cancel over x. Okay, so to cancel over x, so we multiply with x. X multiply with x become x square. Plus, so this one, 6y square divided by x times by x. So the answer is 6y square is equal to 5y times by x, 5y x. Okay, so this one equation number 1 and this one equation number 2. Okay, so step first. First step, so we search the single variable. So from equation number 1, we can see here x. Okay. So from 1, so we have x which is equal to 2 plus 2y. And then this one, substitute into equation number 2. Okay, so yang pertama dah guna, kita ganti masuk dalam soalan equation persamaan nombor 2. So x square, so x is 2 plus 2y. So we have 2 plus 2y square plus 6y square is equal to 5y times by x, which is 2 plus 2y. Okay, so expand this one. 2 square 4. 2 times by positive 2y, positive 4y. Times by another 2, this one. Positive 8y. And then positive 2y square become positive 4y square. Plus 6y square. So this one also expand. 5y times by 2. 10y. 5y times by 2y. Plus 10y square. Then simplify again. So you will have 4 plus 8y. 4y square plus 6y square. So we have 10y square. Equal to 10y plus 10y square. And then pindahkan. Tinggalkan sebelah ni jadi kosong. So you have 4 plus 8y minus 10y plus 10y square minus 10y square is equal to 0. Okay, so we have here 4. 8y minus 10y negative 2y. Okay, so this one, 10y square minus 10y square become 0. So this one equal to 0. So from here, we have negative 2y equal to negative 4. And y is equal to negative 4 divided by negative 2, which is positive 2. After that, find the value of x. Okay, so from this one, we have x which is equal to 2 plus 2y, so which is equal to 2 plus 2 times by 2. Okay, so 2 plus 2 times by 2, which is 4. So 2 plus 4, which is 6. So therefore, we have the answer, which is x equal to 6, y equal to 2. Okay, so another question. Okay, so I think this is the last question, I think. So solve the following system of equations simultaneously. Okay, so here there is no fraction lah. Okay, so terus buat. So this one equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay, so again first step in substitution method. So first we search a single variable. So from equation number 1, okay, so we search x lah. Cari x lah, nak cari y pun boleh. Okay, so tak naklah cari x eh. Okay, kita cari y sebab tadi dah cari x. Okay, so from equation number 1, we have y is equal to 3 minus x. And then substitute into equation number 2. So we have x power of 2 plus, so y, so here y is 3 minus x power of 2 is equal to 9. And then expand x power of 2 plus, so 3 power of 2 become 9. And then 2 times by 3 which is 6. 6 times negative x become minus 6x. Then negative x power of 2 become positive x square equal to 9. Okay, so yang tadi ni cara yang saya baca ni cara singkat lah. Okay, so kalau tak nak cara singkat, tak reti, expand macam biasa. 3 minus x multiply with 3 minus x. Buat macam ni. Okay, and then simplify. So x square plus x square become 2x square. And then minus 6x plus 9. And this one bring to the left become minus 9, which is equal to 0. So this one 9 minus 9 become 0. So you have 2x square minus 6x is equal to 0. Okay, so and then factorize. So macam nak factorize, tak ada C ni. Memanglah tak ada C. Sebab 9 tu lah, 9 tadi dah kosong. Okay, so factorize. Korang selalu suka sangat tekan calculator kan. Tu yang tak boleh nampak tu. Okay, so here, if you can see here, this one is 2x times by x. And here minus, this 6x is actually 2x times by 3. Okay, so from this two side, here minus, so from this one and this one, so we have 2x and 2x. So you can factorize 2x. So we have here 2x. Okay, so the left here is x minus by 3. So which is equal to 0. Okay, so nak mahir ni kena mahir CP lah. Kita kena tengok lah 2x square ni apa darabkan dengan apa. 6x ni pun sama, kita kena tengok apa darab apa. Okay, so cari yang sama lah. Okay, okay, so from this one we have 2x is equal to 0 or x minus 3 equal to 0. So here we have x equal to 0, x is equal to 3. Okay, and then when x equal to 0, okay, so from y equal to 3 minus x, so we have y equal to 3 minus 0. So we have y which is equal to 3. Okay, so when x equal to 3, okay, so from y equal to 3 minus x, so we have the answer which is y equal to 3 minus 3. So the answer is 0. So therefore we have the answer x equal to 0, y equal to 3, or x equal to 3, y equal to 0. Okay. Okay, so finish our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.